to S.N.N. Today is Monday, December 14th, 2015.
It is a hawk day, which means star periods 2, 4, and 6.
A shout out to Olivia and Jen from Flex.N.N. for giving us this amazing background.
It really sets the mood of the holidays and the winter season.
We really appreciate your hard work making our set spectacular.
The phone-in for today is another Name That Tune.
Now in the actual game, contestants stood face-to-face and listened to a tune.
And then pressed a buzzer when they could name it.
We are only playing a fraction of the tune to follow copyright guidelines.
And also to let you hear some of the unique arrangements.
As you can guess, we will play a tune and...
You have to guess what song it is.
100 fake bucks are on the line again today.
Here's the tune.
Three, you can name
that tune. Today.
If you don't have something to wear on Friday, consider a little do-it-yourself project.
Get any sweater or jacket and decorate it to your mind's content.
The funny thing is, the next Star Wars comes out the same day.
I bet many people are going to be Star Wars themed this year.
Ugly Sweater Day isn't just for the school.
It really truly is National Ugly Sweater Day on the 18th.
Friday, be sure to dress it up ugly. Wednesday is a choir concert at the CHS Theater at 7 p.m.
Be sure to go. This is going to be a great concert, and well, I'll be there. Seventh and eighth grade boys and girls trying out for basketball teams must be cleared by Friday of this week,
which is the last school week of the year. Basketball open gym for any seventh and eighth grade boys will be tomorrow, Tuesday, December 17th, 15th at Liberty.
And Thursday, December 17th at Skyridge from 3 to 4:30. If you have any questions, please find Mr. Strawn.
The final volleyball match against Liberty was a success. We beat the Lions 25-16, came behind and won 25-23 in the second set, then took care of business in the third set with an impressive win, 15-4.
The Skyridge 7th grade A team won all of their matches this year except for one.
The team used their understanding of the game to control the ball.
Congratulations on a successful season.
Skyridge is proud of your hard work and determination all season long.
The 7th grade B team traveled into the Lion's Den last Friday. The Lady Hawks lost their first set 25-27.
Only to come back in the second set and dominate the service game.
The third set was a close one, but the Skyhawks ended the game on top of the Liberty Lions to complete their season undefeated.
Uniforms and warm-ups need to be turned in to Coach Youngblood tonight at 5:30.
The 8th grade A team took control early, sweeping the first two games to take the match.
Game 1 was a battle all the way to the end. With our offense and defense in full stride, the rallies were intense.
Alexis Sadler had a great row passing, and Mariana Payne was able to put the power in the down ball and had great serves.
With the aggressive tone established in Game 1, more great back row passing came from Allie Schnell, Olivia Quist, and Maya Ohms in Game 2.
Lily Thompson was on fire, scoring 11 points on the evening.
Great job, girls. We'll have details of their game from Friday in tomorrow's news.
Now here's a special presentation
from our friends at the VFW.
All right, good morning, everyone. And I would like to introduce a special guest from the local Kamiswashugal chapter of the Veteran of Foreign Wars. And here we have Mr. Bob Hitchcock. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
And welcome. And I'll hand it off to him for a special announcement.
Thank you. Again, my name is Bob Hitchcock. I'm the commander of the local post. And with me today, I have Ray Loney and John Butler and Rich Schumann to help present an award. Early on this school year, several of you participated in the Patriot's Pen essay contest. and they were all turned in, and we would like to just kind of give you a quick idea how many there were there.
Right.
Yes. Total out of the area we serve, we cover 33 schools, and we cover 33 schools. We also cover Skamania County. But totally, we had over 600 people join our VFW essay contest. Out of that, 7th grade had 74 people join, and we're glad to say that one of you got first place. So, Bob.
Thank you. I'd like to read the certificate. Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States, Schick Ogle Post 4278, Patriot's Pen Award, in recognition of excellence in the Patriot's Pen Essay Program, you have been designated an outstanding patriotic spokesman for our youth. Signed by myself and the Auxiliary President, Judy Graves, presented to Justin Pendergraft, 7th grade, first place. And along with that comes a gift bag from the Auxiliary of various items, but we also would like to present to you some little remuneration for your efforts, and we really appreciate and we're real proud of you for your participation and how well you did today. All right, very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Gentleman Ray. Thank you, everyone. And thank you once again for your service. Good job, Justine. Congratulations. I guess that's it for me.
Thanks.
And congrats.
Anybody missing the Hawk Mart?
Have you been saving up some tickets over the weeks?
You're in luck, because Wednesday is Hawk Mart Day.
Open at all three lunches.
Make sure to bring your tickets.
So get ready for a popcorn-alicious Wednesday, Skyhawks.
I don't even know how to say today's foodie news.
Traditionally, it is made using the bony rockfish, saffron, fennel seed, and orange zest.
It's a fish stew, but among chefs, there's a right way
and a wrong way to prepare it.
The wrong way could get you chopped.
Seafood lovers love it.
Okay, let's try and say it together. It's National Bouillabaisse Day.
Foodie news reminds me of the upcoming Future Chefs Contest.
That's right. The Future Chef Contest is open. Plus, did you see this sign?
Great pun. The deadline to submit your tasty, healthy recipe is December 17th.
That's this Thursday.
The recipe card looks like this.
All the details and the flyers are in front of the art room. 1, 2, 3. Cook up some fun for yourself and give it a try. The answer to our phone-in was Santa Claus is coming to town.
It's an arrangement from Herman Apple Percussion. Good job to Mrs. Albert's class.
A treat in fake cash will be delivered to you after the show.
That is the news for Skyridge Middle School.
Where hashtag you matter.
Today's thought, be somebody who makes everybody
feel like a somebody.
It's the last Monday of this year for us, so make it a good one.
Remember to follow the code, the Sky Code.
Be safe.
Be respectful.
Be responsible.
And be kind.
This has been Jake.
And Eric. At this time, please stand for the pledge. Ready? Begin.